Police, please! Please, please! All right! Go and phone the police, Rita. Go and phone the police now. Where is he?
Sam's not in there. He's gone to have his hair cut.
Oh, dear.
Alf! Oh. Alf, mate! Somebody give us a hand, will you?
All right, love, all right. He looks to be trapped.
You bloody trap!
Oh. Betty, who's that?
Eh?
Who's that screaming?
I don't know.
Well, see, love.
Are you all right, Mrs. Walker?
Oh, dear.
Oh. Trapped? Excuse me, lovey.
Mama,
oh, I'm not, no. Oh, be careful. Oh.
He looks done for. Oh, dear.
Oh,
dead.
Right, it's all right, Deirdre. Help's coming.
Tracy.
It's all right. Yes, help's coming.
Tracy. What is it? I just got in, you see, and I heard this thud like and all these clattering noises. Must have been all this wood falling off. Ken thinks the driver's dead.
Oh, my God, it's not, is it? What's Deirdre say?
Well, something about Tracy.
Tracy.
We'll have to leave him, Len, till they get here.
You're all right, Elf. We'll have you out of sphere in no time, no danger.
Where you at, love?
It's me leg, personally.
Yeah, well, try and keep it still. You can do more damage if you try and move it.
I can't move.
No, love.
Oh, Mr. Bob.
Horror. He's dead, isn't he? He looks dead.
Now, Mrs. Walker, Alf's not dead. Nobody's dead. And there's somebody here to help us now, so you come and sit down.
What's happened?
Come on.
No, tell me what's happened.
Come on, Mrs. Walker. Come on, love.
A baby?
That's what she says. She's the mother.
Where is she? Why haven't you got her up?
There's people looking. They're looking.
You'll do no good doing that, love. The infection might make things worse.
It's Tracy. It's my baby's under.
Can we have some assistance?
It's all right. They're
get one of you.
We can't do anything here till we get more assistance.
Sarge! There's a couple of fellas. Here in a bad way, Sarge.
How bad?
One's unconscious.
Right. You watch things out here and make sure no one goes near. Put headquarters in the picture and tell them to get me more men down here. It's a major incident. Off you go.
Alf's in there!
Not mine, please. How is he?
Well, he's just about breathing. He was under that lot. It's Alf Roberts. You know, Councillor Roberts.
Alf! Oh, then what is the matter with him?
He's going to be all right, don't worry.
But there's no blood, is there?
No, it's okay.
Hey, how are you?
I'm all right. I've just ripped my shoulder or something.
You've cut as well.
No.
Yeah.
If that's the ambulance, I'll get him in here straight away. Yeah. Now, look, the rest of you, please, can you give us a bit of room and you can go out the back way? Come on, now, let's move.
It can't be hurt, can you? I mean, there's hardly a mark on him.
We know.
Alf! Alf!
Come on, love.
Where's Deirdre now?
Emily's taking her home. Oh, there's no end to it for that poor girl, is there? No end to it.
You're dead right there, Hilda.
That's all the mother said. She left the baby outside the pub in her pram. Well, pushchair. Next thing, wallop.
What's it like, Jack?
A bloody mess, sir.
See anything?
Only one.
Can you hear anything?
Luke! Can we have absolute silence, please?
There's not a sound, sir.
Tracy.
try and drink this, Deirdre. I've put a lot of sugar in it. Deirdre, love.
Tracy wants me.
Deirdre.
Excuse me, Mrs. Sharples.
Look, lovely, you'd be far better stopping in here.
Tracy wants me.
Of course she does, but they have to find her first. And they're looking hard, very hard. Sit yourself down, and they'll come and tell you as soon as she's been found. And she's going to be found, make no mistake about that.
Deirdre, I only left her for a minute. Wasn't it even a minute?
I know, love. I know.
Now, take it easy, Jack. We don't want to do anything to disturb this lot. Just keep your ears pricked. What about the driver?
He'll have to stay where he is for now. The baby's more important. Anyway, he's dead. We know that for certain.
Do you know how serious it is?
Well, he's got a nasty blow to the side of his head.
There's hardly any blood.
Well, there's none coming out of his ears. That's a good sign.
No chance. Have to go out the back. Take him out the back. Ready when you are, Chris.
Can I come with you?
Of course you can, love.
Mind his leg, love. Just
somebody be here for you in a sec.
Right.
Hey, you're going to hospital and all without arms.
No, it's all right.
Tell you what, I wouldn't mind a smoke.
Why didn't you ask me before? I'll get you one, look.
Well, I don't know. 1 minute you're standing having a quiet drink, and the next...
I'm gonna give up going in pubs after this.
That'll be the day.
What's it like outside?
Oh, terrible, love. You just wouldn't believe.
Suppose she does have a child. Yeah.
She's dead. She is. Tracy's dead.
Nay, love. We don't know.
I do.
It's the classic Coronation Street cash bonanza.
Better easy to do it.
It's your chance to win £1,000 cash every day. So, what have you got to do and how'd you win?
That's what I'd like to know.
Well, remember where Mavis was when she got a bit tipsy? Well, if you do, watch out for more magic moments and you could win £1,000 every day. Or a VIP trip to the street and meet one of the stars.
Flip it, heck. Hey, now that's interesting.
Plus runner-up prizes of exclusive classic Coronation Street t-shirts. Just tune in to Classic Coronation Street all this week only on Granada Plus.
What makes a woman alluring? It's difficult to define, but impossible to resist. Every woman has her own special allure. And like a perfect memory, it lasts forever. Allure, the irresistible fragrance from Chanel.
This is the Braun Oral-B Ultra. The difference is all in the head. It's so compact it surrounds each tooth, reaching deep to remove more plaque than a manual toothbrush. Dentists recommend changing your toothbrush every 3 months. Braun say, simply change your toothbrush to the Braun Oral-B Ultra. The Braun Flex Integral. We thought about shaving, so you could think about something else. Braun. Smart thinking.
This is a Christmas appeal from the NSPCC to ask you if you can give £15 now to help save a child's life. Every year in this country, thousands of children are cruelly abused in their own homes. Babies left alone for days without food. Toddlers beaten and bruised, helpless victims of violence. Young girls and boys shamelessly assaulted. And tragically, it's estimated that every week one child under five dies following abuse or neglect. The children shown here are those that made headline news, but for every child you read about in the papers, there are countless more in need of our protection. This Christmas, can you spare £15 to help save a child's life? Your £15 will help us counsel a withdrawn child. Your £15 will help our work with children and parents. And your £15 can help us continue to be there for a child at risk. So please give the best Christmas gift of all and call 0800 597 5000 now. That's 0800 597 5000. We're waiting for your call.
Just can't conceive of it.
Never, ever.
You're crazy.
I'm not crazy.
Wesley Snipes, Nastassja Kinski, One Night Stand.
I feel my heart's beating real fast.
They said action was out. They said Flares had had it. They're both back.
Go, Bodie.
On Granada Plus.
Go, Doyle.
The Professionals. Okay, so they're not the most PC of guys.
Careful, I'm licensed to thrill.
Maybe the action's a little overblown.
Your life or mine.
And the hair's definitely dodgy.
Mine, I think.
The Professionals, tonight at 8, only on Granada Plus.
Oh, that noise. It cuts right into you, doesn't it? I said that noise. The gates of hell will sound like that when they swing open to receive us all.
Well, there's no point in getting morbid, Mrs. Wood.
I'm not morbid. I'm numb. Has the world gone mad, has it?
Well, I mean, these things happen, don't they?
Yes, but why? Why? What is the point? Why all this senseless, stupid destruction of life and property? What is the point of beginning anything, anything at all, if eventually you're going to destroy it?
I wish I knew, Mrs. Walker. I wish I knew. So stupid.
There's no one with this.
Come on, mate, you can keep me coming.
Oh, go on, Len.
I'll just be wasting everybody's time if I go there. There's
no
wrong
with
it.
Do you want me to come?
No, you get back to the cabin.
You must be joking.
Just relax.
Right.
fellas. I think it's something to be ashamed of, don't you? Being ill, doing that. Especially then. Yeah. I know what you're thinking. Not like a Tracy. Not that lovely innocent.
Come on, Bert Lynch. It's time you had a sit down. A spot of brandy wouldn't do you any harm either. Come on.
I'm sorry, Rita. I hardly ever cry, you know. Can't afford to, can you, without mascara and lash on?
Come on.
Just the loose stuff, lad. Don't go pulling at anything.
Is that lad of yours still under there?
Well, don't worry about Jack. He's like a ferret.
You know, I don't know where it all comes from. I think there were half a dozen loads here.
Isn't that always the case?
Yeah. Hey, what's happened?
Where the heck have you been? You've not had your head.
Oh, I got sidetracked. I know what it is. Here, yeah, man, a mess of the road, isn't it? Anybody here?
The only thing, little Trace is under all that lot.
You what?
She was sitting outside when it happened, you see. Isn't that right, Ken? Trace is...
I'm afraid so.
Well, go on, give him a hand. Surely you can forget about your glass back for once.
What the hell do you think I am?
Yeah, he'll help.
I thought there might be a way through there.
Isn't there?
Not really. We'll just have to battle on outside.
Would you like a drink?
I could murder one, love, but, well, you know how it is.
Sorry I asked you.
Well, the thought was there.
Jack's found something, sir.
What?
A kiddie's doll.
Oh, my God.
Ah, but are we absolutely certain that it's hers?
Well, I've not seen her with that one, but, well, I suppose she has a lot. I mean, little girls do, don't they?
It's all my fault.
Pardon?
I started it. I split us all up, didn't I?
Don't be silly, Deirdre, love.
But I did. I split us all up.
Who split up? As far as I know, nobody's split anything up.
First there was me and Ray. Sent him away. Now she's gone. And it's my fault. I started it.
But we don't know she's gone. Has anybody said so, have they?
Families should stick together. That's what families are for. They're like flowers like that. Take one petal away and it's all gone.
Well, I still don't believe that Trace is
dead. That's the word in it. Dead. Like me and Ray. Family's dead, so she's dead too. Follows. It's logical. How are we going to tell Ray? He adored her. He adored.
There's going to be nowt to tell him.
Deirdre.
Best let her be.
Recognise that?
It's Alf's. I'm sure I've seen him with one just like that.
Not a scratch on it.
Oh, dear.
How are you, Cock? Are you feeling better?
Oh, not so bad. Any news of Tracy?
They found her doll.
Oh, they haven't. You know, I never felt it.
What's that, love?
I never felt that glass that cut me. I never felt it hit me. I mean, maybe Tracy.
I'm sure she didn't.
Do you want any help?
I'm not sure I'm actually doing anything, Betty. We can all shovel for me if you want.
I suppose they'll have to close the pub.
Did Mrs. Walker say that?
No.
Can you see her doing it?
No. Well, maybe as a mark of respect.
Aye, maybe that.
Where's Rita?
She's gone to keep an eye out corner shop. Mm-hmm. We'd forgotten there were nobody there with Alf.
Oh, looked to be in a bad way, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, kid.
Come on. Yeah, come on.
Hello? Anybody in? Shop? Hello?
What the hell do you think you're doing? Well, I'm waiting.
I was just seeing if there's anybody in.
There isn't.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll be off.
Let's have a look in them pockets.
Eh?
Your word.
Why, what for?
Let's have a look. And I might remind you there's police out there in the street.
I was gonna pay for them, honest.
Oh. Pigs might fly. Just think yourself lucky that there's people have better things to do. Go on, get out. Go on your bike. Hang on.
Oh, you!
Yeah, go on, go on. I dare you.
I remember you, Missus. No danger.
What wrong with her? You're not going to believe it. We're trying to pinch out at fags.
He would.
Do you know, there's always somebody ready to take advantage, isn't there?
Yeah.
I suppose we'd better show up shop, haven't we?
Oh, well, I've come to keep my eye on it.
Do you know, I think I'll have a packet of these, kid. I could do with some, if it's only a smoke.
Right.
Your husband's all right, I believe.
Thank God.
Mm-hmm. That poor girl, though.
You know, I sometimes think a little prayer helps at a time like this, you know.
No thanks, Mrs. Sharples. You can if you like.
Dear Lord, we pray you look down with love and compassion on this child in her hour of need. Help her to be strong and patient. Not to be afraid. We ask it in the name of thy dear son, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I suppose it is a bit soon yet, but I just thought you might have some. Well, I'll phone again then. Well, when do you think? Right, thanks very much. I just thought I'd phone the hospital. They can't tell me out yet. They've only just got there.
Yeah. Can I have my loaf, please?
Loaf?
Well, I've come away. I mean, there's nothing you can do, is there? And I don't fancy being there when...
Yeah.
Because I know what it's like, you see. Well, in a way.
No, I don't.
Oh, I lost my grandchild, you know, in a car accident in Australia. Oh. I flew all the way out there. 14,000 miles. Only it were too late. Still, I mean, that's a long while since. It's now for poor Deirdre.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going to hospital.
Hey?
Well, Mrs. Walker insisted, you know, she wants me to go and get this cut seen to because of all the dust, you know, that's flying about.
I suppose it's better to be safe than sorry.
Yeah.
How are you getting there?
Well, she's ordered me a taxi. Phew, I feel such a fool. I mean, when you think that all that's happened to Alf and the others.
You feeling all right, lovey? No.
Why? What's wrong?
I've just let go for a minute, that's all. I'm entitled, aren't I?
Yeah, of course you are.
I'll soon snap back into action. I mean, you can depend on that, can't you? Good old Bet.
Always manages to keep a stiff upper lip. Keeps the smile pasted on. It's not always easy, you know, Betty. Not even for me.
I know, lovey. I'll tell you something, shall I?
What?
There's lots of times, you know, and I'm ever so grateful to you for it. I mean, I get up in the mornings to an empty house and... Oh, well, there's not much point to anything. And then I come to work and I think, ah, oh, Bet'll make me smile. And you do, Doug.
Thanks. Hey, did I tell you the one about the Irishman?
Don't you dare. Not be long, Doug.
Don't let him keep you in longer than a week, kid.
Okay.
I heard it, you know.
It might be good news.
We found nothing. Not a sign of her.
Except for the doll.
Are you telling me that the child's not under there?
She's not.
I don't know what to say.
What's the matter, Mrs. Shaw?
Look, you better tell her.
Well, we've managed to search underneath the wood thoroughly, very thoroughly, and there's... Well, we can't find any child.
Impossible.
It's true, Emily.
So, the only conclusion is... Well, she couldn't have been under there in the first place, could she?
Tracy's not dead, then?
Well...
Deirdre, she's all right! Tracy's... All right? Deirdre! The back door's wide open.
The back door? Well, where's Deirdre?
She's gone.
The Champions League on Granada Plus. Newcastle's final game against Dynamo Kiev live.
Magnificent.
And Manchester United. Can Juventus be toppled again?
An astonishing goal.
The Champions League. Newcastle versus Dynamo Kiev live. Plus highlights of Juventus versus Manchester United. Wednesday at 7:30 on Granada Plus.
This is a Christmas appeal from the NSPCC to ask you if you can give £15 now to help save a child's life. Every year in this country, thousands of children are cruelly abused in their own homes. Babies left alone for days without food. Toddlers beaten and bruised, helpless victims of violence. Young girls and boys shamelessly assaulted. And tragically, it's estimated that every week one child under five dies following abuse or neglect. The children shown here are those that made headline news, but for every child you read about in the papers, there are countless more in need of our protection.
And a time for every purpose under heaven.
This Christmas, can you spare £15 to help save a child's life?
A time to dance.
Your £15 will help us counsel a withdrawn child. Your £15 will help our work with children and parents. And your £15 can help us continue to be there for a child at risk. So please give the best Christmas gift of all and call 0800 597 5000 now. That's 0800 597 5000. We're waiting for your call.
Subscribe now and save £6 on the cover price of a magazine that covers every subject on Earth. Every month, you'll receive up to 140 pages with award-winning photographs of the breathtaking, the unusual, and the beautiful.
let world-class writers such as Paul Theroux and Bill Bryson, and leading experts from Jane Goodall to Johann Reinhardt tell you the full story behind the pictures. You'll also receive up to 5 free maps that chart the ever-changing world we live in. A subscription to National Geographic delivers the best and nothing less. To receive a magazine that covers everything on Earth for just £24 per year, call 08000 686 686 and subscribe for yourself or as a gift for a friend.
All the best of Christmas fare. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa campers. All your favourites will be there. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa campers. Shopping vouchers for the high street. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa. All your family you can now treat. Park campers.
To become a Park Campers agent for Christmas 1998, call free on 0800 58 68 78 to receive your free catalogue. Pay from only 50 pence a week. Spread the cost over 45 weeks. And as a Park agent, you could receive a free gift and earn up to 25% commission. You could even win a share in our £30,000 free prize draw. So call free on 0800 58 68 78 to become a Park Campers agent for Christmas 1998. Park Campers, the biggest Christmas savings club in the land.
Fancy some fun tonight? We've got classic Coronation Street at 6:30. How about something a little cooler? Scylla's got a blind date or two lined up at 7. And at 8, things hot up as Jonathan and Jennifer get heart to heart. Explosive stuff. Every weeknight, 6:30 to 9 on Granada Plus.
Pram, no baby, just the doll.
But the baby must be somewhere. Shouldn't you...
Now, let's leave it to the CID, shall we, Mrs. Bishop? They've been called in. They'll be here any minute. No point in repeating yourself. I'll tell you what would be appreciated. The lads have been doing a rough job out there. Is it possible to organise some tea?
I'll see to it.
Why don't you sit down, Mrs. Bishop? And don't worry, love. We'll find them for you.
Thank you, sir. Mm. Hello, Mrs. Bishop.
Hello.
Detective Inspector Brewster, Weatherfield CID, and this is Detective Constable White. Quick recap, George.
Right, sir. A Mrs. Langton, who lives here with a 2-year-old baby.
It's my house, but we're very good friends.
Lodges here, I should say. Now, apparently, Mrs. Langton went into the Rover's Return, that's the pub on the corner, a few minutes before the crash. Now, according to her, she leaves the baby in a pushchair just outside the pub door.
According to her?
Yeah, well, as soon as the crash happens, she gets hysterical and tries pulling all the rubble off, you know.
I see. Anybody else see the kiddie outside the pub?
I haven't checked that, sir.
Right, go on.
They bring her back here, Mrs. Langton, that is, and you say she went quiet.
Very quiet.
Yeah, and then about 10, 12 minutes ago, they managed to get a fireman far enough underneath the timber to say definitely there wasn't a kiddie underneath. I come here, and while I'm talking to Mrs. Bishop at the front door, Mrs. Langton opts it out the back. So I didn't get to see her. And that's it, sir.
Do you think Mrs. Langton might have heard that the baby hadn't been found?
No, she couldn't have done, because I didn't say anything about it at the front door.
Yeah, but she could have thought, if she heard your voice, that you had brought bad news.
Well, she could have done, yeah. Oh,
that's what I thought.
Oh, and that's another funny thing, sir. We found the doll underneath the timber.
But no pushchair?
Not a sign of it, sir.
And this is the little girl's doll?
Well, it must be, though I don't remember seeing it before.
Now, what do you think... I'm sorry.
Just wondered if you'd like a cup of tea.
No. What do you think might have happened to the baby?
I've no idea. I work at a confectioner's in Rosamond Street. I was there when the accident happened. I just came round as soon as I heard.
I see. Or, Mrs. Langton, you've no idea where she might have gone?
No.
Have you found it?
At the back, did you say?
On the right, behind the cylinder.
Oh, yeah, I've got it.
Good.
knew it was up there somewhere.
Right, who wants this?
I'll have a go.
Have we got any dusters?
I think it's a bit early for dusting, don't you, dear? Why not stack the furniture all on one side?
Good idea, Mrs. Walker.
How's everything out there, Kate?
Oh, it's looking a bit clearer, Mrs. Walker.
Blessing about Tracy.
It's a mystery.
Well, I'm afraid there's been another development. Deirdre's gone.
Gone?
How do you mean, gone?
Just vanished. I went round with Sergeant Cummings to tell her that nothing had been found under the wreckage, that is, apart from the doll. When we got there, Emily met us at the door. And when we went in, Deirdre had gone. Apparently, she'd just walked out of the back door.
When was this?
About 10 minutes, quarter of an hour ago.
Oh, as if she hadn't gone through enough.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be organising some tea for the people helping out there. Could you help with some cups?
Do it all here, lad. Find everything you want in the kitchen and Bet'll give you a hand.
I most certainly will.
Of course, you'd be looking for Tracy.
No, she didn't know she hadn't been found. She didn't hear anything.
There are some things one can't bear to hear.
They did their best.
All of them. They did their best.
Ah, let's see. Incidentally, where's Mr. Langton? Does he know about this?
He's not here. He's in Holland. She's had rather a bad time.
Yes, I remember you did too. Still, how has Mrs. Langton had a bad time?
Well, about 18 months ago, she was attacked by a man.
What have we got on this?
No, she'd never reported it to the police.
Didn't she? Go on, please.
Well, then her marriage... She separated from her husband. She was supposed to go with him to Holland, but she decided to stay here. And then just recently there was an upset about selling the house and she came to stay with me.
How's all this left her? In what state of mind?
Well, I'm not... I hadn't thought about it, really.
Melancholy?
I wouldn't say melancholy.
Moody?
She did have moods, yes.
Was she given to flights of fancy, say?
Flights of fancy?
Well, suppose she hadn't taken Kitty to the pub when the crash had happened. Could she have thought that her baby was underneath all that rubble?
Oh, hardly think so. Mentally, she was perfectly all right.
Perfectly?
Yes.
Then she's very lucky. We hardly live in a perfect world. Okay, get back to the lads, George. I'll take it from here.
Right, sir.
Mrs. Bishop, I'm going through the possibilities. Now, that's all. Just the possibilities. And in cases like this, there's an awful lot of them. One is that Mrs. Langton took the baby to the Rover's Return and left her outside in the pushchair.
Well, it seems to be the only one. It isn't here, so she...
Yes, but
she
it hasn't been found yet.
No. Don't you think...
We should be looking, yes, of course I do, and we are. But we do need a lot of help. Now, if you could give Detective Constable White here a few details. Don't worry. We'll find them. Oh, I'll be sending a constable down just to look around the house.
Why?
Oh, just routine.
Could I have Mrs. Langton's full name, Mrs. Bishop?
Why do they want to search the house?
Oh, it's like Mr. Brewster said, just routine. Mrs. Langton's full name?
Deirdre. No, it's Deirdre Ann.
Deirdre Ann. And the baby's Tracy?
Tracy Lynette. She was 2 in January. I'm her godmother.
And Mrs. Langton, how old is she?
Well, I'm not sure. I think she's 24.
That's fine. And a brief description?
Well, she's quite tall. 5'7", I'd say, or perhaps taller. Slim. Long, straight, fair hair. And she wears spectacles, glasses, big ones, the modern kind, big round ones with plastic frames.
Good. Now, what was she wearing when you last saw her?
Oh, isn't it silly?
It's not easy at times like this.
No.
o'clock, then.
Right, anything I can do to help, Mrs. Walker?
Don't think so, dear. Tea's all organised, is it?
Yes, Bet's just bringing it through now.
Oh, dear. I really think, you know, she ought to take it out the back where it's still terribly dusty in here.
Yes, right, I'll cut. So, Ben, I think perhaps better take it out the back where it's not too clever out in the front.
Oh, well, are you helping yourself, Will,
here? Oh, why not?
Yeah, me and all. Ooh, it's proper acrid, that dust, isn't it? The very word, Mrs. Abdon, the very word.
Now, who do you want me to give them to? Because I've got plenty more in the back.
I think anyone in uniform.
Or who looks as if they've been working. We'll leave it to you.
Yeah, see, Mrs. Ledbetter gets one. You know, that little woman from Clarence Street. Oh, did you see her when they asked for volunteers to start pulling that wood away? Went at it like a mad thing she did, and she's only the size of sixpenny copper. One of the policemen told her to slacken off, she were putting them to shame. Oh, it's funny, you know. Never really noticed her before.
There are people who thrive on tragedy, aren't they? No, no, that is unfair. There are people who give their best at times like this.
It's a good job there are, isn't it? I mean, heaven knows they're needed.
Yeah. I'm glad my stand's not in fire brigade.
Oh, I don't know, Hilda. We could roll him over at flames. He'd have a mounted quick sticks, wouldn't you, Stan?
Yeah, well, that's true enough. Oh, but when you think of some of the jobs them lads have to do. Because it's not only fires, you know. I mean, there's train crashes and pile-ups on the motorway. We've only seen the thin end. Some of them messes don't bear thinking about.
Aye, they've got to go in and sort it all out.
Yeah, heaven knows how they get used to it.
If they ever do.
Aye.
We don't know we're born, do we? We don't, Hilda. We certainly don't.
Right then.
Yeah, come on, Dolly Daydream.
Right.
We'll never get straight.
All right. Well, if that's tea, I wouldn't say no to a cup. Detective Inspector Brewster, Weatherfield CID.
You're definitely entitled. Help yourself.
Thanks.
Any way we can help?
Oh, you certainly can. I'm interested in the time leading up to the actual crash. I understand that Mrs. Langton came in a couple of minutes before it happened.
Yes, she did.
Well, you may not know this, but she has...
I do know she's missing.
I see. You spoke to her, I believe.
Yes, I did.
Did anybody else?
I believe that my barmaid had a couple of words.
Could I have a couple of words then to both of you? Yes. Somewhere quiet, preferably?
I'll get a bet for you.
Will you come through?
Thank you.
Well, goodness knows what's happening to that poor girl while they're doing their talking.
Yeah, well, they're going to have a job to find her without a few pointers, Hilda. The right word can put them in the right direction, and that can save a lot of precious time.
Well, I hope you're right.
And she came in here?
Oh, yes, yes, she was here. We were both here in this room when it happened.
What did you say her mood was at the time? I'm still talking about before the accident.
Well, much as usual. Normal. I mean, she wasn't laughing a lot, but she's not had a lot to laugh at lately.
Yeah, so I understand.
Yes, I'd agree with that. She was perfectly normal.
Now, I want you to think carefully about this one. She gave you the impression that she'd left the baby outside in the pushchair.
She told me she had. I think. Do you know, I'm not sure now.
But did either of you actually see the baby or the pushchair?
No.
Well, do you know anyone who did or might have done?
Wait a minute. Alf Roberts came in at about the same time. What are you after exactly? Are you trying to find out just about where the pram was?
Oh, that sort of thing. Alf Roberts, you say?
Councillor Roberts. He has the shop at the end of the street.
That Mr. Roberts?
They've taken him to hospital, you know. He was badly knocked about.
I see. Do you mind if I use your telephone?
No, of course not. In the hall, do come through. I found the number for you.
No, thanks, sir. I know it. These are the kind of numbers we remember. Casualty, please. This is Detective Inspector Brewster, Weatherfield CID. You've got one of my men there, a Constable Conway? Put him on, please. Oh, he's right there. Good. Look, Conway, there's a Councillor Robertson there brought in after the Coronation Street accident. Now, just ask him if he remembers the position of a pushchair with a baby in it that was supposed to be outside the pub about the time he went in. What? I see. Thanks.
Well?
He's still unconscious.
What did she say was up with you?
Two busted ribs, slight concussion, fractured ankle.
Couldn't have happened to a nicer fella.
How come I get all this lot and you stand there as if you just cut yourself shaving?
Most drunks know how to fall.
Yes. Now then, which one's yours?
This one.
Oh, well, he's as good as new, just waiting for his x-rays.
Well, what's he been x-rayed for?
He complained of pains in his chest. Oh. Probably bruising. We're just making sure.
Have you got the feeling you're not here?
You can tell there's not much wrong with him.
How are you, love?
Shall I tell you which bits are all right? A bit quicker.
There's no wrong with him.
Hey, they don't keep you in hospital these days. Not if there's no wrong with you.
Thanks for those few kind words. They're the first I've had. I wouldn't have minded, only I just got around him. It was his turn next. Friend of yours, that lorry driver, is he? Eh?
He's dead, love.
Oh.
They think he had a heart attack, so he were probably dead before he hit Rovers.
That'd explain it, wouldn't it?
Yeah. How's Alf?
Oh, that's a good question. I haven't seen him since we came in.
There was nothing I could do, so I came back here to the shop. I hadn't even locked up.
Rita Fairclough kept an eye on things.
Oh, that was very good of her.
How was he when you were...
Oh, didn't come round.
Well, don't you think you ought to be there when he does?
Oh, Mrs. Sharples, I can't stand hospitals. I have a dread of them. I just have a dread. I just have.
I'll go with you. Look, nobody gets much pleasure out of hospital visits, I know. But there are times when you've got to forget your own likes and dislikes. Remember the marriage service? In sickness and in health? Now, it's said about whether you like hospitals or not.
Yeah. Will you really go with me?
Of course I'll go with you. Go and get your coat.
Thanks.
Yeah. You'll feel better when you get home.
Oh, yes.
A cup of tea or something. Hey, look who I found.
Hello, Betty. Hello. How are you, love?
Oh, I'm all right. Mrs. Walkround have insisted that I wouldn't have been here at all.
How is he?
He'll live.
Speak for yourself.
I've been trying to find out about Alf, but they tell you nothing, you know. I mean, according to them, he's still in x-ray.
He's been in there a heck of a long time, hasn't he? Yeah.
Well, that's what I was thinking. Is Rainy here?
No, she's gone home. Oh. Well, it would be better that she were occupied than sitting in casualty worrying herself sick.
I just wish they'd tell you more in these places.
Yeah. Hey, they're taking the time with your x-rays.
Is there something else wrong with you?
Only his heart.
His heart?
Hmm. They won't be able to find one on picture. It'll be worrying them.
Oh, she's joking.
I wish you lot had shut up. If I'm in bed, I might as good be a kip.
Is he doped? Oh, well. I'll get off because I've been cleared.
Oh, well, hang on. I've got a taxi waiting.
Oh, no, it's all right. You'll be a while yet, lovey.
Thanks very much.
Well, you will. I mean, they've got to make sure. Yes. Anyway, I'll see you later.
See
you. Oh, is there anything you want me to do
no,
when I get back?
No.
Did they find Deirdre's kid? Did they find her?
Well, they will have. I mean, they're very good. I'll get back.
I'd forgotten about the kid.
You're leaving it entirely in my hands.
Well, we couldn't very well open as things are, could we?
The law on licensed premises is extremely complicated, and one can't be too careful. So, if somebody comes in opening hours and is desperate for a drink, we'll serve them.
Well, let's just hope nobody's daft enough to try it.
Well, our stand thinks you're closed, so I don't see why everybody else shouldn't.
There you go.
Are you there? We're in here.
Oh, good. I hope you don't mind us coming in this way.
Of course not. We're just off to the hospital.
I've had to close the shop. Well, there's a buzz at 8:30.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah, the 151 stops outside Matthews's.
That's it.
Oh, Elizabeth. Oh, I'm all right.
Hey, kid, it suits you, that sticking plaster. Yeah.
Are you just off, love?
Yes, did they say?
No, they didn't. But they're taking care of everybody down there. They're wonderful. Come on, we'd best be off, love.
Yeah. Thank you.
He's not so good from what I hear.
Oh, bless him. Oh, you just can't believe it, can you? One minute everything's normal, people laughing and talking. Come on, love. Come on, you're going to have a lie down.
I'm all right, really.
Come on, love. Come on.
How about you, Betty? You all right?
Oh, I'm all right. It's only a scratch.
They're just moving the lorry. Is Mrs. Walker in?
She's just gone into the back. She's not so good.
Oh, I see.
I think you should. I think it's up to you.
No way.
Len, if you don't, nobody else will.
Then nobody will.
Hey, hello, love.
Hello, Lisa. They're bringing me in now.
We'd better get out of the way, then. Is there anything I can fetch for you?
Yes, I've forgotten his pyjamas and shaving things. Could you just...
Yeah, I'll fetch them for you.
Thanks.
Is it in? Any news of the baby?
Her body were done at mess. She were never there.
Thank God.
Where is she?
Nobody knows. It's just a mix-up. A complete mix-up.
You're cleared, Mr. Fairclough. See your doctor if your shoulder gives you any more... Ah, would you stand back, please? Mrs. Roberts.
Say one for all of us, will you, love? We're not all that good at it.
Good cup of tea, this.
Yeah, I bet you never thought you'd live to see the day you'd be drinking tea in a pub.
No, I didn't.
Yes, at times like this, you think there are a thousand things that you should have done and you've forgotten every one of them.
You know, I was thinking exactly the same thing. Exactly.
Hello.
Oh.
Hello. You weren't so long then, look.
No, you'd only just left.
Oh. Somebody's been busy.
Mrs. Walker's gone to bed. She's not feeling so good.
No. Any more news? Well, go on then, put it to them.
Well, there's no to put to them. Look, you can put it to them if you like, but leave me out of it.
Well, I think Ray ought to be told.
Are you against it, Len?
No, but what could he do? I mean, if I was to get in touch with him, he'd have to come over, wouldn't he? I mean, by the time he got over here, the police had probably found the pair of them.
Well, don't say no news is good news, for God's sake.
I wasn't going to say that. I'm merely saying that's how it could work out.
Well, what do you all think?
Well, I'm inclined to agree with Len. I think there's enough of us worrying as it is. I mean, Ray couldn't do anything, could he? If the police want him, they'll send for him.
Might be too late, then. If anything happened, he'd never forgive us.
Oh, that's just a risk we'll have to take.
Testing.
This is going to be a decent do.
The sausage roll, little canopy.
No, no. There's going to be no drunkenness or disgusting behaviour.
Gold, frankincense and myrrh.
Neon and red leaves and
for you and me, dear church.
It's a madhouse over there.
I've been trying to get it off since tea time.
Happy days are here again.
In Apple.
Christmas on the street.
In Apple Blossom Town.
Sunday at 3 on Granada Plus.
This is an appeal from Oxfam to ask you for £2 a month to help some of the world's poorest people. What if you had to stand by and watch your crops fail because the ground was too parched to nourish them? What if you had to walk 6 hours in the baking sun every day just to get enough water to quench your thirst? What if your children were forced to drink water so dirty that you knew it might kill them? And what if all you had to do to help change lives like these was to call Oxfam on 0800 31 31 31? Just £2 a month from you can help a third world community build a well to give them clean, safe water for life. Help farmers water their crops for harvests that will feed their families year after year. And pipe water to villages so people don't have to walk miles to find a drink. People in the third world don't want handouts. They just want the chance to work themselves out of poverty and live dignified, independent lives. So call Oxfam now on 0800 31 31 31 and give £2 a month or whatever you can. Please, call us.
We love Christmas, and it's so exciting getting our hamper from Country. I'm an agent for Country, and you can be one too. With Country, you get everything you need for a great Christmas. Meat, veg, drinks, sweets, even gifts and jewellery. Top brand names too. And shopping vouchers you can use in thousands of high street shops. You can spread the cost over 45 weeks or more, and pay from just 50 pence a week. And when you're an agent, you can earn up to 25% commission. So why not join me and be a Country agent for Christmas 1998? Call free on 0800 50 5000 now for your free catalogue. You could claim a free gift when you become an agent, and even win a fantastic holiday in Spain in the £30,000 free prize draw. Olé! So just call free on 0800 50 5000 and start planning your perfect Christmas for 1998.
From the people behind the award-winning TV series Wild America, we now bring you a 60-minute video featuring unbelievable wildlife images. See dramatic close-ups of wild animals as they hunt for food and follow their great escapes in some of North America's harshest landscapes. Be amazed by their fight for survival. Enjoy the animal kingdom as you'll probably never see it again. Order Great Escapes now, and we'll also send you an extra 30-minute video, Wild America, a compilation of 10 years' best pictures. Experience a sea lion's life, follow salmon and the grizzly bears, a crocodile hunt, and animals in their natural habitat. Watch nature's own Olympics with its greatest athletes. These fascinating wildlife videos are available now from TV Shop. Call this number and order Great Escapes at this TV offer price. Our operators are waiting to take your call. Phone now.
A murderer's most dangerous weapon.
We have ourselves a serial killer.
Is the mind.
What do we got?
Consensual sex and bondage.
Introducing Fitz, a brilliant new drama based on Cracker.
Are you asking for my professional opinion?
In a chilling UK premiere.
Revenge, execution.
Of mind games and murder.
Anyone's a potential victim.
Fitz premieres Wednesday night at 10 after Newcastle United live in the Champions League on Granada Plus.
You feel so flaming helpless.
Yeah, that's why I thought I'd come and get some of Alf's stuff, you know, his shaving, tackling his pyjamas and that. Well, you feel as if you want to be doing something, don't you?
What do you think Ray would do exactly if you told him?
Well, what could he do? I mean, I could tell him, couldn't I? That's all. Your wife and kid have gone missing. Half the police in Lancashire are looking for them. But what good would that do? I mean, by the time he got over here, they'd both be either tucked up in bed or else they'd both be... what the hell could he do then? I mean, bring him back to life.
You're right, lovey. Leave it as it is.
What the hell's going on?
We've had an accident, that's all.
Half the pub front's gone, and that's all you can say. There's been an accident.
It's serious, Eddie.
Yeah, lorry turned over, and we got the load of timber.
Flipping it.
The driver stuffed it.
I died of a heart attack.
That's what caused it.
Anybody else? I mean, do we know?
Well, Alf's bad. He's still in hospital. And Mike Baldwin.
Ah, he's not so bad, though, is he?
No, not so bad.
Deirdre and the kid have gone off missing. We don't know what happened to Tracy at all, but Deirdre just walked out. Disappeared.
I mean, it was only up at Monkey's, only half a mile away, but it's a different world. Nobody knows.
Only happened a couple of hours ago.
Oh, yeah. It feels like a lifetime.
I'd better get off anyway.
Are you going to the hospital?
Yeah, I've got to take some of Alf's stuff back, you know.
Could I come with you?
If you want to, it's up to you.
You feel as if you want to do something, don't you?
Aye.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Walker. I thought you might have been fast asleep.
No, dear, the pill doesn't seem to be working. Any case, I'm better up. Let's have a drink, shall we? Is there some left in the pot? No, dear, I mean a proper drink.
That's
we all
a good
need
idea.
It. Oh, well, right, then, let's have your orders. Emily? No point in breaking down at times like this.
True, Elizabeth. But if you don't, you feel there's something wrong with you.
I think I saw his eyes flicker. Did you? Did you see his eyes flicker?
No, love, but don't worry. They will. God will grant you patience.
Oh, I hope so, Mrs. Sharples, because I'm not very well endowed with it.
Have you had much experience with family ailments or bereavements?
No, not really. My mother's an invalid when it suits her.
Is that your impatience speaking?
Yeah, I suppose it is.
You know, it's not very evenly spread. I have known women that have never had a carefree week in the whole of their existence. There's always been summit. If it hasn't been a child, it's been a husband, it's been themselves. Sometimes seeing God puts them on earth as a good example to us to show us how lucky we are. He'll pull through. It's a wonderful creation, the human body. If it wants to have a rest, by heck, it'll have a rest, and no doctor on earth will shift it. He'll open his eyes when he's good and ready.
Yes, but...
Yes, I know. You want to be there when he does. That's why God will grant you patience.
Those for Mr. Roberts?
Yeah, they're just his pyjamas and shaving stuff and that.
I'll take care of them. Don't stop too long, will you?
No. I do.
Hi.
How are you diddling?
Oh, not so bad, mate. How are you?
Great. You're not so bad. What are you doing in here?
Got me strapped to the bed.
No kidding.
Near enough. Move a muscle, they got the exits guarded with shotguns.
He had concussion, that's why they've kept him in.
It's a funny thing, that concussion, you know. Do you know, you can walk around with it for ages and not know you've got it. And then suddenly, pow!
Oh, thanks very much. Who's your friend, a registered hospital visitor sent here to cheer us up?
Oh, you're all right. I mean, you're catered for. Anyway, you can't fall down, you're already on your back.
Aye, so be thankful.
Yeah, you're on Easy Street. Do you know, it's a long time since I've been in one of these hospitals. Not bad, is it?
Well, play your cards right, you can have this bed. I mean, wait for the rush hour, play in the traffic, get yourself knocked down by a small juggernaut. Solve all your problems, Edward.
Do you know, it might be worth a couple of weeks, a broken ankle. What's the grub like?
Don't know, I'm trying to get. Bit of luck, I'll be out before the next meal comes round.
You three look for all the world like you're planning the next train robbery.
We're thinking of taking over the hospital. We're going to take you hostage.
Not today, love. I'm off soon. Wait till my next duty starts, eh?
Oh, when are you off? I'll take you wherever you're going. I don't care.
You stay where you are.
Yeah, you want to watch him, you know. Otherwise, he'll be out the window.
I'll slap his legs if he doesn't behave.
Oh, might like that.
Don't be too sure.
Excuse me. How do I get to spend some time in here?
Qualify as a surgeon. I'm sure you've got it in you. And keep quiet.
Is that Alf?
Yeah. Is Ina still in there with Rini?
Yeah.
Do you know, when you look at the front of the Rovers, it's a wonder nobody was killed. I mean, it's like Scotty Road when the bulldozers moved in.
It felt like the flipping bulldozers moved in and all.
Hey, who's doing the rebuilding job? Are we bidding?
No, the brewery will do that, won't they? Hey, I tell you what, though, they probably want some temporary boarding up, don't they? Nip in and see Annie when you get back.
Yeah, oh, right.
I wish you two had stopped talking shop. I'm supposed to be suffering here. Ah, now he can talk shop.
Hi there.
Hi there, he says. Right, thanks, fellas. And next time, if there is a next time, bring some in, eh?
Yeah, we forgot, you know.
Yeah, I know. I've got a memory like that.
I will see you.
Yeah, see you. Well, come on then, tell me. Am I bankrupt yet?
Oh, give us a chance. You've only been in a couple of hours.
I don't want it, really. I couldn't.
You could and you will. Now, look, a drop of brandy never hurt anybody. Look, now, come on, get it down, you. I mean, it's not just me you're up against now. You know? I mean, what's Mrs. Walker going to say when she brought it special? Oh, no. Oh, you mustn't blame yourself, lovey.
No, it's not. I don't. It's that little girl, that baby. I thought it was over for them. I really did. I thought it was over for them.
I know, my love. I know. Come on, sit down. And it will be when they get back. They'll be very happy with you, you see.
Take that little elephant, you know, Deirdre. I mean, why did you take the little elephant?
Hey, who knows what goes on in the minds at times like this? They'll find her, love. The police are ever so good when it comes to things like this. And I'll go. Now then.
Oh,
hello,
Mrs. Sharples. She's not too good.
Oh, come on. Hey, what's all this now?
Hello, Mrs. Sharples.
I've been trying to get her to drink that tea. There's a drop of brandy in it.
Well, if she won't drink it, I will. Mm. Come on. Drink it up.
Do you think we ought to go out and help look for them?
No, we don't go look for them. There's lots of people out there looking and they know what they're doing. In any case, your place is in here. Who's going to look after them if they come back and you're not here to do for them?
Yes, that's true.
Of course it is. I'll get the door on my way out.
All right.
Now, look, if there's anything you want, just phone the Rovers, right?
Yes.
All right. Well, see that you do.
All right. No more.
Yes. Would you like to go straight through?
Thank you very much indeed.
Is there any news?
Not as yet, Mrs. Bishop, but it's early days, don't worry.
Like a cup of tea?
Oh, I wouldn't say no. Thank you. Mrs. Sharples, isn't it?
That's right. I'll go make some fresh.
Thank you. May I?
Yes.
I'm just rechecking one or two points. The doll we found under the rubble, you say you assumed it belonged to Mrs. Langton's little girl.
Tracy, yes.
But you'd never seen it before?
No, she had lots of dolls, but I'd never seen that one.
So we can assume it was a new one.
Well, I suppose so. I think I saw all those she got for Christmas. Do they know about the little elephant?
Yes,
the people...
yes, they do, but we're not concentrating on a young lady carrying a child's toy. If she picked it up unthinkingly, she could just as unthinkingly have dropped it. You know, people who go missing under these circumstances are noticed. They do strange things, excite attention. That is why we find them. And we'll find her.
Doctor, is there anything else you can tell me?
Not a thing, Mrs. Roberts. We know your husband has a fractured skull. We know we need further observation, further tests, a brain scan.
What's a brain scan?
Mrs. Roberts, just because we go looking for trouble doesn't mean to say that we find it. But routine says we have to look. Under the circumstances, your husband is progressing perfectly normally. In fact, I'm worrying less about him than I am about you. Let Nurse Phillips know as soon as you want to go home. It's not the slightest point you running yourself down.
No, I think I'll stay a little longer.
All right. He's in very good hands, you know.
Hello? How are you?
Not too bad, love. Any change?
No, not yet. There we are. I knew she'd had some more recent ones taken.
Well, let's hope we don't have to issue it, but thanks all the same.
I really came along to let you know about them in hospital.
How are they?
Well, out in a bad way, bless him, but we'll know more about him when he opens his eyes. But she's the only one, though. The rest are all progressing, thanks be to God.
It could have been much, much worse. We were just talking about this doll.
Oh, yes. What doll's that?
The one we found under the rubble.
This one?
Oh, that's the one that girl gave to Tracy.
What girl?
A girl that came round at dinner time, round about 12:30. Didn't he give me her name, but I've forgotten what it was. Early 20s, long dark hair, thin, skinny little thing. She gave that doll to Tracy.
That sounds like... Was her name Sally? Sally Norton?
That's it, Sally Norton.
Do you think this girl's involved?
She could be. She was strange, withdrawn.
She'd had her own baby adopted. That's how I knew her. She struck up a friendship with Deirdre. She was always wanting to take Tracy out for walks. I'd forgotten she was coming today. Deirdre was going to send her away, nicely, I mean, but neither of us really trusted her. Why didn't I think of her before?
Do we have her address?
The hospital will.
Well, she could be the key. I'm not one for wild guesses, but it could be if we find the girl, we find the kitty.
Come on, Mummy will take you home.
My manager promised years ago, he said, do it right, Bill, and you can have your name in pink.
Billy Connolly?
It's decidedly average to be here.
Well, thank you.
I've never seen so many famous people in my whole life. It's like a party at our house.
Laugh?
The national anthem is boring.
And cry?
Now I think the Queen should be saved. And if anybody's going to save her, God's the very chap.
Tonight at 10 on Granada Plus.
Isn't it funny how every Christmas there's always something you haven't got in your pocket?
That's why this Christmas, Asda have got 2,000 new ideas, all at permanently low prices. Like 24 lagers for a duty-free £4.79. A sledge load of mixed snacks in boxes of 50. A feast of frozen treats like hand-finished gattos and mini pavlovas. 2,000 new ideas and permanently low prices forever. That's Asda price.
It's Christmas!
More gifts for less, welcome to the MVC Countdown to Christmas and the MGM Greats.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
10 classic movies from Hollywood's golden era.
You do such wild and unpredictable things.
Each with the original theatrical trailer and a film guide with full synopsis.
Good night, honey.
MGM Greats, 10 films you'll want to see time and again. The MVC Countdown to Christmas, our choice of the best CDs and videos at low prices.
Argos has heaps of Christmas gift ideas. For a precious mum, for a gorgeous girl, for a talkative aunt, for your prettiest daughter, aren't they all? For your star performer, for the spaced out twins, for your handyman, for your own special spice. Please them all at a price you'll like. Pick up a December copy of Argos Plus now.
New Alka-Seltzer Excess. When you've had one too many.
The Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition. New scenes, new sound, new special effects. The Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition. Available for a limited time only.
Polaroid.
For more ho 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 this Christmas, go to Smith's. You'll find shooting stars unpicked and plucked.
Right, there's something terrible's happened. I've lost me cap.
Let me see.
And Red Dwarf extended.
I won't be revolted no matter how you look.
Okay.
It's hideous.
Whatever they're into, get into WH Smith. They said action was out. They said Flares had had it. They're both back.
Go, Bodie.
On Granada Plus.
Go, Doyle.
The Professionals. Okay, so they're not the most PC of guys.
Careful, I'm licensed to thrill.
Maybe the action's a little overblown.
Your life or mine.
And the hair's definitely dodgy.
Mine, I think.
The Professionals, tonight at 8, only on Granada Plus.
That's it then. Early 20s, 5'2", thin, brownish hair, and she's wearing a long check coat with brown boots, and she's got pink gloves. And hopefully she's pushing a baby in a pushchair. Let's cruise around the park for a bit. You never know your luck.
Yes.
Eddie Yates wants to see you, Mrs. Walker.
Oh, no, that's all I need. I've got this dreadful headache coming on. What does he want?
Well, something about boarding up the front, only I remember that you said what the brewery said, you know.
Oh, yes. Goodness gracious, ask him to come in.
Right. OK, love.
Afternoon, Mrs. Walker. Len asked me to come.
Oh, and I'm so glad you came. Do you know, I'd completely forgotten all about it and I intended to get in touch. Could you board up the front as securely as possible? Only the brewery won't be able to rebuild for another couple of days and they asked me to get in touch with someone local to do a temporary job.
First thing in the morning. Business as usual, is it?
Yes, business as usual.
Right, we'll have the boarding up long before opening time, so it should be all right. It'll be like a speakeasy, won't it? Like in the old Prohibition days, you know. Elliot Ness and the Untouchables.
Really? I think we'll have to lock up the spirits each night until the job is properly done.
Yes, Mrs. Walker.
Thank you very much for coming. It had completely slipped my mind. It's not surprising on this day of days.
No, very true, Mrs. Walker, very true.
I won't keep you, love. I gather from them you're not very well.
Come on in. I'm all right. I just keep going up and down every 5 minutes to have having a better spell now.
Oh, good, yeah. You've had a word with the lad, have you?
Yes, I have.
Yeah, first thing in the morning, all right, boss?
Fine.
Right. And may I say how much I'm looking forward to working in a pub, Mrs. Walker?
Really? I don't see why. It's much the same as working anywhere else. Except that we expect a higher standard for rather less money. And we don't give pints of beer instead of cups of tea.
Oh, no, no, I wasn't thinking of that, no. I was thinking it's an opportunity to give of your best, you know.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, well, I'll be getting on.
Let's move on. Hold it. Switch your engine off. I think we've got lucky.
They found that kid, Jack.
What kid?
The Langton kid. Deirdre's little girl.
Oh, no, not as far as I know. Last I heard, they were still looking.
Still looking for Deirdre as well?
Yeah.
How's that Goldstone order doing?
Now, how long do you reckon you've been in here? Shall I tell you? Just over 3 hours. They're working on it. It's going fine. I'll tell you what I do want from you, though. Take a look at this. That's the price you gave Masons. Now, I was on to Billy McDowell there just before lunch, and they want to go into court, but the price is frightening them. So I reckon if you shave it a bit, not too much, just enough, then we're in, and that could grow into something really big.
I'm glad I never had any kids. Nothing but trouble when you've got them coming and going. She must be going through murder, that bird.
Well, I never knew you had it in you.
I am human, you know.
Yeah, but only just.
She's not the only one. I mean, take Ray Langton. Supposing you were him and the worst came to the worst, what do you think it's like losing your family? Bang.
Well, he lost them months ago.
Don't kid yourself. Not Deirdre. And certainly not that little girl. It is his daughter, you know.
Yeah.
You don't switch off that easy. Not when you're that type.
What type's that?
My type, that's how I know. I'll tell you someone else that'll make you laugh. I envied that lad.
What, Ray Langton?
Yeah, he cracked it. Did his playing around, got himself a good wife, nice little kid. Then he couldn't stop playing around, so he lost them both. That's what would have happened to me. Yeah. I know what he's going through, all right.
I don't think they've told him.
Is that so? Oh, well, I just lay here and do the worrying for him. Got nothing better to do.
Except shave this price for Masons.
You do it. Who said that?
Oh, certainly not the Mike Baldwin I know.
Yeah, well, don't worry. He'll soon be back.
Yes, I know he's worse off, Mrs. Sharples, but at least he's in hospital being cared for. Heaven knows
no,
where...
I won't tell you again. You're a grown woman. Act like one.
I'm sorry.
My Cyril used to say our daylight was a copper's best friend, you know, at times like this. They used to hate to be sent out on searches just as it were getting dark. So, I mean, they've got all the afternoon.
They'll be found long before the afternoon's over, which doesn't give you much time to prepare yourself, young woman. That's better. She wants a calm, happy host to come back to, not the wailing wall of Weatherfield. If I know anything about Deirdre, she's thin enough tears to last her a lifetime.
It's Tracy I keep thinking of. I can't help it, Mrs. Sharp.
Hey, she won't know anything about it. Bless her little heart.
I know, but what about that girl? I mean, suppose she does something.
Oh, come on, what can she do? Pushing a wheelchair about and every policeman in the district looking for her.
I know, but if she's deranged and sees the police, she could panic. She could...
Stay where you are. Stay where you are.
Oh, wonderful. Emily! Emily!
Go on.
My darling.
Right, take her away.
Oh, sweet. Is that the girl who took Tracy?
Yes, it is,
you
Mrs. Bishop.
You terrible girl, you terrible, terrible
now,
girl.
Now, Mrs. Bishop, come on.
Darling.
You'd best take the child inside.
Yes, yes. Okay,
thanks, love. Nice work. Thank you, sir. That young woman just walked into our arms and thanked me for the lift. I know that. You never know what's going to happen next. So, let's find the mother. Right, sir.
It's ironic, isn't it? I mean, if that girl hadn't taken Tracy...
Oh, it doesn't bear thinking about.
I feel like a spare part sitting here. Oh, I'm going to get the van out.
Yeah, I think I'll go for a walk too. You never know, we might find something that the police have missed.
I'll come with you, lovey.
Well, I don't think we've been much use.
No, we'll stay here.
She's not a bit tired. She's sleeping quite happily. Where's everyone going?
Oh, we're just going scouting round.
You lend a hand.
Can I come with you, Len?
I don't see why not.
Oh, I'll get my draw, love. Have at it.
Bye. Bye.
Hey, I don't know. As if she hadn't got troubles enough of her own, she has to go looking for somebody else's. I don't think you've got much to talk about in that respect, Mrs. Sharples.
Mrs. Langton? Mrs. Langton, we've got the baby. We've got Tracy.
Why didn't you bring her up?
We can't. She doesn't believe that Tracy's still alive. She could jump in.
Oh, dear God.
Stay here. I'm going to fetch Tracy.
Hey, she's chattering away to herself up there.
It's amazing how self-sufficient children are. Little girls, mostly. Little boys cling to their mummies and then leave them.
Get Tracy down. I'm taking her. We found Deirdre.
Is she safe?
Yeah, let's hope she stays that way.
Mrs. Langton, we've got her. We've got the baby.
Got Tracy. Tracy's here.
Something entertaining on Granada Plus. At 9, classic Coronation Street, and at 9:30, there's another right pair.
A stitch in time
saves nine.
Too many cooks
spoiled a broth.
A watched
suppository never dissolves.
At 10, it's a cult classic. And they don't come any more classic than Hawaii Five-O. Arresting entertainment every weeknight, 9 till 11 on Plus.
I'm smart, you're dumb.
I'm big and you're small.
I'm right, you're wrong.
And there's nothing you can do about it.
No kid likes being yelled at, but it was precisely Harry's ranting and raving that gave Matilda the key to her power. To unlock that power, all she had to do was practice.
No more Miss Nice Girl.
Roald Dahl's Moving Tale Matilda, now available to own on video.
Surround sound by Philips. Tested on humans. Philips.
What are we going to do now?
The Spice Can from Polaroid.
Of Mayfair. It's not just the thought that counts, it's the chocolates.
I'm Murray Walker, and my video, Murray's Magic Moments, features 20 years of Formula One thrills. The good times, the bad times, the great drivers, the great battles, and my unforgettable Murrayisms, all on Murray's Magic Moments. Fantastic!
Murray's Magic Moments, out now.
I see trees of green, red roses too, I see them blue.
Childhood should be a time of wonder, but for many children worldwide, it is a time of hardship, hunger, and sickness.
What a wonderful world.
You can change that. By sponsoring a child through Plan International, you give a future to them, their family, and community, and it costs the equivalent of just 40 pence a day. That money builds schools and clinics and provides clean, safe drinking water. In return, you'll receive regular letters from your sponsored child. These children are desperate for your help,
So call Plan now on 0800 440 770. Please give a child a future today.
Make someone happy this Christmas.
Great. Telly for the bedroom.
Come to Comet.
You're two middle-aged, unemployed blokes.
So enjoy a little bit of danger. Nigel Havers and Keith Barron are the good guys. Weekdays at 2 on Granada Plus.
The Godfather says, watch Alfresco tonight at 9:30 on Granada Plus. Or he'll send his boys round.
That should keep the draft out.
That's one job we could have done without.
We could have done with that yesterday altogether.
Hello, Betty.
Hello. I still feel ill thinking about it.
I would the same. If I had a load of 2B8 come through my public bar.
Oh, terrible, weren't it? Terrible.
Like a flipping bomb going off, wasn't it?
Well, I thought I'd get here early, see what he's doing.
Yeah, you're right, Betty. You know what they say? What? Opening time waits for no man, even if you have got no front windows.
Hello, Rainy, love. Any news?
No, I'm on my way to see him now. Oh. I've had to close shop. There's nothing else I could do.
Oh, you get up to well. That shop will be there when you come back, love. Yeah.
Hey, I could run you down in the van. It'll only take me a couple of minutes.
Oh, no, Len, really, no. Well,
the last thing you want today is walking a mile, isn't it?
No, Len, thanks all the same, but honestly, I'd rather.
Oh, well, let's hope they've got a bit of good news for you, lovely, when you get there.
Yeah, thanks. Oh. Ta-da.
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 Oh, ain't it a shame?
I could have been down there in 2 minutes.
Perhaps she needs a bit of peace and quiet, love.
Would you like a cup of tea now? I was thinking I might make one.
Oh, no, thanks, Emily. I don't think so. Thanks all the same. Do you know, we could go on forever without mentioning yesterday.
Well, everything's all right now. That's the main thing.
Yeah. I won't forget it, though.
There are some days you never do forget.
Do you know, I thought of throwing myself in that canal. I remember trying to think of reasons not to. I thought, with Ray gone, I've only got Tracy left, so if Tracy's gone too, it was as simple as that. I mean, my mind wasn't confused or frantic or anything like that. Everything was crystal clear. It wasn't so much that I wanted to do it. I just couldn't think of a good reason not to.
That's all finished now, Deirdre.
Yeah. That's why I can talk about it. Yeah, I mean, you don't mind, yeah?
No, but... You'll find it'll become part of the past. Everything does.
Oh, nurse!
Yes, Mr. Baldwin?
Can you sort these pillows out for me?
Can't you manage them yourself, you poor old soul?
I'm a sick man.
Yes, of course you are.
And when's the doctor coming round? I've got things I've got to do.
Unlike the rest of us. Dr. McLaren will be round later this morning.
Good. Now, is there any chance of getting her a phone in this place?
Yes, as soon as it's free. The ward phone's being used at the moment.
Darling, I've got a business to conduct. I need a phone.
There are other patients in this hospital.
Yeah, well, they can write letters or something.
Oh, I didn't realise you were so special, Mr. Baldwin.
Mike. You can call me Mike, darling.
Can I?
Yeah. And what's your name?
Nurse Phillips.
Yeah, I know, but you weren't christened Nurse Phillips, were you?
No, strangely enough, I wasn't.
So what's your full name, then?
Full name? My full name is Staff Nurse Phillips, Mr. Baldwin. Excuse me. I'll let you know as soon as the phone's free.
How is it this morning, nurse?
Well, there's no real change in his condition, but the night nurse said he'd had a very comfortable night, and we've given him a bed bath. Oh. Now, don't worry, will you, if while you're with your husband, the nurse comes in from time to time to make observations and do things. It's only routine, all right?
Yes.
And there's a buzzer at the top of the bed, so if you see any signs of him coming round, you'll let us know straight away, won't you?
Yes. Yes.
Come and have a look at him, then. Now, you just stay as long as you like.
Thank you.
Have you eaten?
What?
Have you eaten something this morning?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Good. Well, I'll bring you a cup of tea, though, shall I, in about 10 minutes or so?
Thank you.
Right. You give me a buzz if you want anything.
Thanks.
You know, I think it's marvellous the way you're carrying on, despite the building being in ruins all around you.
It was only a window that went.
Oh, isn't she great, eh? It was that attitude that saved this country during the last war and during the Blitz. The Rovers return. We never close.
What do you know about the Blitz?
I've seen it on the telly, didn't I?
I remember being here during the war. I was on leave. Yeah. And they dropped a bomb at the end of Inkerman Street. Huh?
What did you do, run for your life?
No, they were here. We grabbed our pies, went under the tables. I mean, you couldn't go out because the bombing was on.
You must have had it hell in those days, Stan.
And what happened when you'd supped up?
Well, we waited till it went a bit quiet, then nipped out and filled them up, you know.
You know, your generation had it dead rough, didn't you, Stanley?
Oh, aye. We saved your bacon, that's a fact.
Gee, why should Britain tremble?
You don't think it could be, do you, that he doesn't want to speak to me to break the news?
Pardon, Mrs. Walker.
Mr. Creswell.
What about him?
Well, I rang up Newton and Ridley's again this morning and they said he was out. Can't help wondering.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Walker, but I don't know what you're on about exactly.
Now, you heard what Eddie Yates said yesterday about that public house that was pulled down after it had been damaged in an incident.
Oh, and you think that they might...
Well, we could easily think we were immune and then find the bulldozers at the door.
But they sent that surveyor chap to check over before we could reopen. I mean, he said it was good for another 50 years yet.
Elizabeth, dear, I am not saying that the Rovers is going to fall down about our ears, but sometimes a brewery, if they want to transfer a licence, they seize on an excuse like this to close down what is, after all, one of their older premises.
And you think they might transfer? I mean, like you said.
Well, unfortunately, shan't know the answer to that until I've spoken to Mr. Creswell.
I think you'll find it for someone in Alf's condition. There'll be no visiting restrictions at all.
I better get over there. What the hell I'm going to say to it, I don't know, but I'll find some.
Yeah, well, Rena, you'll certainly be glad of your moral support.
Aye.
Give her my love.
I will, dear.
Take a
marriage
for half an hour.
Oh, take as long as you like, Mrs. Walker. Not enough in to keep one of us busy.
I think I'll have a little lie down. I don't seem to have your rugged indifference to the future.
Well, that's because I never had much of a future to worry about.
Call me if it's necessary.
I will.
You know, it's nice to be able to do that, isn't it? If I lie down, it costs me money.
Shall I say it or will you?
I think you better say it. I'd only use bad language.
I'd like to lie down. I'd take the afternoon off. I think the shock of yesterday, you know.
You weren't even here when it happened.
I was here in half an hour, wasn't I? I got the gory details from Hilda.
Oh, yes, Stan. I think you better go to the hospital and have a proper check-up, you know.
Yeah, I think I will. If I don't feel better after this drink.
If there were only something I could do.
Well, you're doing it, aren't you?
What?
Being here for when he comes round. You know, talking to the patient could help.
Talking?
Hmm. You see, we're not really sure just how much a person in a coma is aware of. So the sound of somebody's voice might just spark off a reaction. I mean, a particular voice.
You mean just talking about anything?
Well, something that he could remember or know about. Something important to him. Now, is there anything I can get you?
No, thanks.
You're all right, then?
Yes.
And you can only have the phone for one call at a time, I ask you.
Aren't you glad of the rest?
My idea of a rest, mate, is a 5-star hotel, not a 1-star hospital ward. Ah, and here's a little darling that's going to get me away from all this, aren't you, love?
Something troubling you again, Mr. Baldwin?
I was just telling my mate, Mr. Fairclough here, that you're going to get me into a private ward with a phone that doesn't keep walking away.
Only when there's one free.
Yeah, but you can do it, love.
I might have known you'd find a way of chucking your money around, even in here.
Well, if I can't spend it on myself, who can I spend it on?
Have you come to see Mr. Baldwin? Because it's...
It's Mr. Roberts, Alf Roberts.
You a relative?
No, I'm a mate. A very good mate.
All right. His wife's in there with him at the moment. In you go.
Thanks. See you later.
Yeah.
How do?
Len.
I just had half an hour to spare. I thought I'd pop in.
Thanks.
It's nice. Anything to do? Have they told you out?
Just that there's no change.
Hey, is it your anniversary? Today? Oh, completely forgot about it.
They look so daft at home, so I brought him here. But what good are they here?
It's something for him to see when he comes round, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose so.
So that's where they should be.
They said I should talk to him, the nurse said.
What about?
Well, about anything he might respond to. Will you do it, Len? He knows your voice. Will you do it?
Yeah, I'll have a chat with Alf any day of the week.
Alf? Alf, love? Len's come to see you.
I've just been down to the Rovers. We were talking, you know, about this and that. There's a few anniversary cards there for you. I forgot as usual. Your anniversary, I mean, not the wedding. That's not something you'd forget in a hurry, is it? Although some of us were a bit late, if I do recall. Remember? Rita and me turned up about 10 minutes after kickoff. Me with a gammy leg and her with a face like thunder. You remember? Still, it all turned out all right in the end, didn't it? We had a good do, really. You had a fight, if I remember.
Hello, Mrs. Sharples.
Hello. I thought I'd just come along and see how you were getting on after yesterday.
Oh, recovering, I think. Sit down, Mrs. Sharples. There's a cup of tea in the pot.
Well, it's not doing any good in there. Better pour it out.
Tracy's just gone down for a nap, so I don't think there's much wrong with her.
Good. What about you?
Oh, well, like I say, recovering.
Well, you've had a rough time, lass, and no mistake. And now what? You're going to take yourself off to your mother for a bit?
Well, I thought about it, and then I thought, my mum will never let it drop, and it'll just be like reliving it all again. So I'm stopping. And there's something else I feel as well. I don't know, I feel as if I've been given a second chance, you know.
Good for you, lass. It's time you had a bit of luck.
We must make sure she gets it.
Yes.
There we are.
You. So, what about that other young woman, the one that walked off with Tracy?
What, Sally Norton?
Yes, what's going to happen to her?
Well, I don't know. I've not really thought about it, Mrs. Sharples.
Suppose the police...
She wants locking up and all them like her. But she'll get away with it, I expect.
Yeah, it's difficult to feel much sympathy. I mean, when children are involved.
Waste my time trying.
Oh, I must admit, well, some of the things I said, I rather shouted at her yesterday. Well, I do feel a little ashamed.
Yeah. Well, none of us were thinking too clearly, were we?
Well, I know what I'd do with her if I would my way. And I'm sure you feel the same, being the mother.
I'm not really sure that I do, Mrs. Sharples.
Oh?
Yeah, well, when you think about it, I suppose she saved Tracy's life. Sally, I mean.
Well, accidentally.
Yeah, but it's what she did, though, really. And I'll always be grateful to her for that.
Mr. Baldwin.
Nurse Phillips, you couldn't keep away.
Not when the sister asked me to come and have a word with you, no.
About the private room?
Yes, there is a room free if you still want it.
Oh, well done, darling.
Nurse Phillips.
Darling, Nurse Phillips.
Yes. Now, you do understand the arrangement, don't you? This'll be what we call an amenity bed, for which you'll be charged. Now, that doesn't mean to say you're in here as a private patient. You'll still be treated under the National Health Scheme, OK?
Perfect. Be nice and cosy for the two of us in there.
Well, for special patients, and of course you are a special patient, we do have certain extra treatments available.
Yeah?
Yes. For example, today you can have a cold water sponge bath and a bladder washout. No extra charge.
Oh, thanks. I'll just stick to the phone, thanks.
Thought you might.
I can't think of what else to say.
Do you think he heard any of that?
It's hard to say, isn't it?
Oh, it's hopeless.
No, it isn't. The doctors and nurses don't think it's hopeless.
Did they tell you that?
Yeah, of course they did.
If he'd just open his eyes, just move.
He will. You just give him time, that's all. How long is it since you had?
Oh, I'm not hungry.
There's a sort of a cafeteria place downstairs. I'll stay here with him.
Yeah, I suppose I'd better have something.
Go and get yourself a cup of tea and something to eat. You can't live on fresh air forever, you know.
No.
Be as long as you like.
Thanks, Len. Thanks for talking about the wedding and everything.
It's all right. It may have helped him.
It helped me.
Well, Alfred, my old son, what else shall we talk about?
14p, please, Kenneth.
Thank you. Will you have one, Mrs. Walker?
Well, that's very kind of you. Help me, I will, thank you. I've got rather a headache.
She's still worrying about the pulling this place down.
Who put that into her head?
Well, she seems to think it'd be cheaper than putting a new window in. I don't follow myself, exactly.
Oh, this lad'll have a drink, I'm sure.
I could stop the cup dry, I'll tell you.
I told you I'm
sick
this afternoon,
Len. I had about half an hour to spare, so I thought I'd pop in. It did save Reenie a bit of trouble, you know.
How is he?
Well, to tell you the truth, I can't really tell you. I don't know. He's still out to the world, you know, not a flicker on his face. He's got one of those drip things on his arm.
Is that
old
Robert you're talking about?
Yes, Len's just been to see him this afternoon.
How is he then?
Well, like I was saying, I don't really know. He's just lying there. I mean, whatever they know, they're not telling us anything.
There's a telephone call for you, Mrs.
Oh, thank you, dear.
Mr. Creswell.
Oh. Oh, excuse me.
Oh, right.
I tell you what, though. I don't think Reenie will stand much more of it. A few more days down there.
The shop's been closed all day.
I think it'll be closed a bit longer and all.
Looks like a load of trouble for them pair, then. Well, there'll be compensation, won't there?
Yes, I suppose so. I mean, the lorry will be insured, won't it? And then the, well, the brewery's bound to have some...
I don't think she's too bothered about that now, is she?
Hey, Stan, do you hear that? They're going to get compensation, them that were involved in the accident.
You mean doing claim for the after effects?
Well, we could try, couldn't we?
We?
Yeah, well, I think it's affected my nerves and all, you know. The knowledge that I could have been standing on the very spot. I mean, it doesn't bear thinking about. I mean, look at that. That must be worth a couple of thousand.
Yeah, I didn't think I could come in here again, either. Well, that'll
be the trauma, you see.
The what?
The trauma, Stanley. It can affect the habits of a lifetime, you know. You get yourself a good QC, you can retire early to the Bahamas. We both can.
It's not a flipping joke, you know. If you think it's so funny, go down and tell Alf Roberts. You might get him to laugh.
Sorry, Len, I was only...
It's the first thing you'd think of, isn't it? Compensation.
Well, I was the one that mentioned it.
Well, it was only a joke, mate.
Well, some good news amid the gloom, I'm glad to say.
What is it, Mrs. Walker?
Well, I know that other people have bigger problems, but that was Mr. Creswell on the telephone, and I'm very relieved to be able to tell you that the future of the Rovers has never been in any doubt.
Well, I'm sure we're all very glad to hear it, Mrs.
I could think of better news.
Well, it's nice to have something to be cheerful about, Len.
Yeah, why don't we have a flipping party while we're at it, eh?
Listen, Len Fairclough. There isn't anybody here that isn't truly sorry about Alf Roberts, but that's no reason why we should all go about with long faces 24 hours a day, no matter what. It's never been as into smile, and it's not going to be made one here.
Oh, here you are, then.
Oh, hello, sunshine. Come in.
I see you've been pulling rank again.
Nothing to do with rank. Come on, sit down. And...
I brought you these.
Oh, thanks. That's nice. Oh, yeah, very nice. If you can afford these, I'm paying you too much.
I knew I shouldn't have bothered.
You'd have been fired if you hadn't.
I can't win, can I? Didn't take you long getting in here, did it? And there's me thinking we had a National Health Service with no privilege.
No privilege. Same treatment. I'm just paying for the frills, that's all.
Yeah.
Oh, and talking of frills, there's Nurse Phillips been looking after me. Looking after me like I was a baby, guarding me day and night. I think she fancies me, you know.
Is he like this all the time?
Most of it.
Yes, well, I'll keep those for you while you're in here, Mr. Baldwin. No smoking in the private rooms.
Hey!
I believe you now.
What?
About there being no privilege.
Oh, well, don't worry about her. I'm working on her.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Hello, Mrs. Roberts. Want to see me, dear?
I'm sorry to trouble you, but...
It's no trouble.
Well, it's Alf, you see. It doesn't seem to be showing any signs at all.
Not yet, no. The thing is, Mrs. Roberts, your husband has had a terrific blow to the back of his head. Now his body needs time to recover. I mean, it obviously wouldn't do for him to be running about and exerting himself in all sorts of ways. And this is why the body puts itself into a state of unconsciousness, to give the system time to recover.
Oh, well, how long do you expect him to be like this?
That's something we can't predict. I mean, as with everything else, different people react in different ways. In the meantime, we're doing all the investigations we can.
But he is going to be all right, isn't he?
Your husband's condition, Mrs. Roberts, is what we would expect it to be at this stage, following his accident.
But when do you expect him to come round? Tomorrow?
There's no such thing as a normal length of coma. Every individual is different.
I see.
I would say that your husband's condition is relatively encouraging.
Then they turned around and said, have you got anyone at home that can look after you? Of course, like a mug. I said, no. So they said, oh, well, in that case, you'll have to stay in for a few more days.
Oh, so that means it could be a good few days then?
Oh, yeah, at least.
Oh.
So what's going to happen to Mike Baldwin Enterprises by I am laying in here like a dummy, eh?
Well...
Answer, they will carry on as usual. And do you know why?
Why?
Because I've got this highly trained and very capable young man waiting in the wings, ready to step into my shoes. Didn't tell you about him, did I?
No.
Oh, yeah, well, it's only until I'm ready to step back in. And do you know who this man is, waiting to take my place at any time?
No.
Well, can't you guess?
Well, do you mean me?
Well, there's a clever boy. Carefully selected and trained for just this situation. Anyway, there wasn't anyone else, was there?
Oh, thanks.
Oh, now, don't you play hard to get as well. Look, I'll tell you the truth. And mind you, I don't do this often, but in this case, I make an exception. To tell you the truth, I've been thinking about this for quite a while. You know, letting you take over, take the reins for a bit. Mind you, I didn't exactly picture this, but as it is, it's just come along a bit quicker than I thought it would.
So I'll be in charge then?
You will be in sole and total command, my son. How does that suit you?
Look, I'm sorry about you being stuck in here.
Oh, yeah, I bet you are. Like hell.
You'll want to be kept informed, though.
I would appreciate the odd word, yeah.
Right.
Now, look, I don't have to brief you on what takes priority, do I? Because you know all that already. Now, don't forget that Newcastle order has to go out next week. Everything else has to wait, right?
Don't worry. I know. Leave it to me.
Right, if you have any trouble at all with the girls, see Ivy, right?
I can manage. You never know what I might have achieved by the time you come back. Soaring profits, turnover doubled.
Well, you do that and I'll be very pleased. On the other hand, if anything goes wrong, you know who'll be taking the can, don't you?
It's the classic Coronation Street cash bonanza.
Very easy to do it.
It's your chance to win £1,000 cash every day. So, what have you got to do and how'd you win?
That's what I'd like to know.
Well, remember where Mavis was when she got a bit tipsy? Well, if you do, watch out for more magic moments and you could win £1,000 every day. Or a VIP trip to the street and meet one of the stars.
Flippin' heck. Hey, now that's interesting.
Plus runner-up prizes of exclusive classic Coronation Street t-shirts. Just tune in to Classic Coronation Street all this week only on Granada Plus.
Every time you watch a Disney video this Christmas, something magical happens. So full of enjoyment and wonder, it's the one Christmas present they'll want to open again and again and again. Give a Disney video and make the magic happen.
When you're on the phone to friends or loved ones, do you ever feel you've got to stop short so you don't run up a whopping bill? If you free call cable and wireless now on 0500 500 500, you can relax. Until the end of the year, a long-distance weekend call to anyone in the UK will never cost you more than 50p, however long it lasts. That includes Christmas Day, Boxing Day and New Year's Day. What's more, when you switch to cable and wireless, we make this promise: either savings on your total call charges or double the difference back. And you'll get 100 minutes of local evening calls absolutely free every month. Switching to cable and wireless is easy. Simply free call 0500 500 500 now for more information about making savings on your phone bills and taking advantage of our special 50p weekend call offer. That's 0500 500 500. The lines are open round the clock, and in just a few days, you could be running on for as long as you like.
If you pay off your credit card every month, or every other month, you can afford to ignore this commercial. However, if like me and 9 million others you don't, you can't. Like other credit cards, Royal Bank of Scotland MasterCard is recognised and accepted all over the world. But this card is different from most leading credit cards. Because Royal Bank MasterCard has always charged 14.5% APR. Check that against TSB Visa, Midland Visa, Barclays Visa, or NatWest Visa. That's about 50% more than Royal Bank MasterCard charges. There's no annual fee, and you needn't even bank with them. Interested?
For more information on Royal Bank MasterCard, telephone 0800 16 16 16 now.
The Champions League. Newcastle versus Dynamo Kiev live. Plus, highlights of Juventus versus Manchester United. Wednesday at 7:30 on Granada Plus.
It's that time of year again. Oh, happy days. Christmas on the street. Saturday at 3 on Granada Plus.
I've not come shopping, lovey. I've just popped in to see how... Oh, sorry.
Oh, sister. Hello. I'm inquiring about Mr. Roberts. How is he this morning? It's Mrs. Roberts. Oh. None at all. Oh, thank you. I'll be along later. Thank you. There's still no change.
Well, at least they've not said he's got worse.
Oh, it's been 4 days now, Betty.
Yep, I mean, I've read, you know, where people have been out for much longer than that. Weeks sometimes, and then they come round as right as rain.
Sometimes when I see him just lying there, I think he'll never...
Now, stop it. That'll get you nowhere, lovey. Alf'll be back shouting the odds before you know where you are.
I want to believe you.
Look, it's nature's way of healing, lovey, you know, like sleeping it off when you've got the flu.
Have you any idea what you're on about, Betty?
Well, the important thing is to keep cheerful at a time like this. I mean, for your sake as well as his.
Cheerful?
Well, you know what I mean. I mean, look on the bright side. If you're always going to be expecting the worst... Well, anyway... You haven't slept, have you? I'll get you a nice hot drink, and then you're going straight to bed, and that's the boss's orders.
Oh, I can't, Betty. I'll have to keep shop open for a couple of hours yet, and then I'm off to the hospital.
You're never thinking of keeping this place open, the state you're in. Oh, look, you'll collapse.
Collapse if I don't. It's the only thing to do, you know, is keep going.
Give me Steve Fisher, will you? Well, Mike Baldwin, who does it sound like? Here, is that you, Kat? Ida? Well, what are you doing answering the phone, and where's Steve anyway? Oh, no, tell him to phone me directly he gets back, will you? At the hospital. Yes, he's got the number. Cool.
Sorry, that's enough.
Oh, now, come on, darling, use your strong arm tactics on the doctors, not on me.
Other patients want to use this phone, you know. It's not for your exclusive use. Anyway, you've got a visitor.
At this ungodly hour of the morning, tell him to go away.
It's only me, Mr. Baldwin. You don't have to worry if you're not looking beautiful.
Hey, what are you doing here? You should be at work.
That's all gratitude I get for dragging all this way here and fetching you this.
Well, could at least say thank you.
You're supposed to be tending my wounds, woman, not me manners.
It's from all girls we've had a whip round.
Yeah, well, thanks. I just phoned the factory. Steve's not in either.
No, he's had to make a call at Clifton's first thing, only it's the only time Mr. Clifton could see him.
Oh, well, as long as he gets a good order this time.
Only one of you should be there, you know. I mean, who's looking after the shop?
It won't fall apart, you know, just because both of us out for half an hour. It's only time I could come in. Anyway, girls are all in.
Are they?
You know your trouble, don't you?
What?
You don't trust nobody. You think that everybody's going to take advantage of you the minute your back's turned.
With good cause, darling. They usually flaming well do.
All right. I don't want to overstay me welcome. How long before you get shuttering?
Today, if it was up to me.
Look, all I need is the love of a good woman to tend for me in my hour of need. Any takers?
Oh.
Yeah, my old dad was right. There are no good women.
And aren't you glad?
Now, listen to her. She's evil. I thought all nurses were supposed to...
Oh, that's a good way of shutting him up. Hey, I wouldn't mind borrowing that.
See how she speaks to the boss. You wouldn't talk to me like that if I was on my feet again,
now,
would you?
Now, look, would you mind...
Now, just a sec, darling, then you can have me at your mercy for the rest of the day. Lucky old you. Ivy, look after Fisher for me, will you?
How do you mean?
Well, I've had to leave him in charge temporary, and I think he'll be able to cope, but...
You mean keep a motherly eye on him?
Yeah, that sort of thing. I mean, he's bright enough, but he is still a kid, you know.
Oh, not old and experienced like us, eh? Right, look, you just get yourself fit, and will you stop worrying?
All right.
All right.
Ta-ra. Ta-ra, love. Thanks for coming.
She seems nice.
Yeah, she's all right in patches.
You don't know your luck.
Oh, don't I? Morning,
I see Vera's in.
Oh, yeah.
Good, where?
What?
Where's she hiding? Under the bench?
She's only gone to laugh. She'll not be a minute.
I see.
Here, you're supposed to be at Clifton's.
Oh, yes, well, I did get there, only Mr. Clifton's off sick with food poisoning, unluckily for him. And as it turns out, unluckily for you, too.
Oh, I've only been doing a bit of shopping.
Yeah, and who clocked you in? Was it Ida?
Yeah, she was just doing me a favour. Anyway, I can make time up.
Of course you will.
Oh, that's all right, then.
For the moment.
Here, what's he up to?
No.
He's up to something, I can tell.
Will you stop fretting? He won't do all. It's too wet him anyway to take all us lot on his own. Hello?
Dan.
Dan.
What are you doing here? Where's Rini?
Oh, I'm standing in for an hour or two. She was itching to get to the hospital.
How is Alf?
No change.
That's a shame, isn't it?
It is. She'll have a breakdown, you know, if she goes on the way she is. I mean, I can't help full-time as much as I'd like to. How about you, love?
What about me?
Are you still out of work?
Till I get a decent job, yeah.
There you are, then. You can step in.
Here? Oh, you must be joking.
Well, why am I? I mean, Rini needs help. You need a job.
Slicing flaming bacon? I'm not that desperate, thanks very much.
Not even if it means helping out a friend.
Rini's not exactly... Oh, come on, Betty, have heart. It's all very well you being Mrs. Fixit, but I've got my own problems to sort out. Look, I'm on my way now to the job centre. What if they offer me something fantastic? I can't do it down for this. All due respect.
Yeah, you're right, lovey. I mean, they might offer you top modelling job for Hartnell's.
Or...
lady-in-waiting to the Queen. I'd hate you to miss out, love.
Pupils are equal. Pupillary reaction quite brisk. Have you noticed any response?
No, Doctor.
No response to sound stimulation?
No, Doctor, nothing at all.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doctor, I didn't know.
That's all right, Mrs. Roberts. I'm just on my way. You can come in.
It's still the same?
I'm afraid so. But we're doing everything we can, I promise you that.
Yes, I know you are. It's just that it's so...
I know. Waiting's the worst part.
He's very nice, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
It's just that sometimes you can't talk to him, you know. They make you feel 6 inches tall, but he seems quite human. Will it be all right if I put that on there?
Yes, of course. Is this on holiday?
No, it was just a day we had out at the Yorkshire Dales. It was a lovely day, and... well, I thought it might be nice for him to see when he comes round.
Yes, of course.
Is it all right if I come in for a bit?
Well, so long as it is just a minute.
Thank you. How is he? No change.
Oh, I don't know. I sit here and talk to him, but nothing. Not even a flicker.
It'll happen.
Yeah.
What about you? You don't look too good, you know. You'll have to take a bit of care of yourself as well.
Well, I mean, with the worry here and shop to run.
Well, can't you shut it for a bit?
Well, I can't, but then I don't really want to. I mean, I want something to occupy my mind when I'm not here, and trouble is getting somebody to run it when I am here.
Who's there now?
Betty, but she can't stop all that long. I mean, she has her own job to see to.
You're the one who's going to crack up next, you know. All this dashing backwards and forwards. Then who's going to look after me, Laddery, when he gets back on his feet?
Well, not much choice, have I? I could get my mother, I suppose, but she'd be useless in shop. I'd have more trouble then than I have now.
Well, it must be someone.
So tell me, how does he look, eh? Is he all bandaged up like a mummy?
No, he's not, you goon shaper. She's never happy till she sees blood, this one.
Dear, I can't imagine Baldwin all bashed up, though. He always looks so immaculate.
Yeah, I wonder who does his washing for him.
Why, are you thinking of volunteering? Hey, he's going to want somebody to look after him for a bit when he comes out. Hey, I wouldn't mind sucking him up, but I don't think old man would stand for it.
Nor would Mike Baldwin. There's a lot of talking going on.
Yes, well, we can talk and work machines at the same time, so happens.
Yeah, we're very gifted that way.
Cut the jokes, will you, Vera? We'll be well enough behind as it is with you two skiving off this morning.
Well, we're skiving. You know very well where I was, I told you.
Yeah, but you didn't have to go to the hospital in working hours now, did you?
Yes, I did. I explained to you.
You should have asked me first if you could go, shouldn't you? Not just do it off your own bat.
Hey, give over. We are flipping boss you went to see and all, you know.
I haven't forgotten, Vera, and I haven't forgotten about this morning either.
What about this morning?
Oh, no.
I wouldn't say that, Vera. As a matter of fact, I'd like to have a word with you about it. No, not now. We've wasted enough time. Before you go to dinner.
Hey, that's in my time.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
The cheeky old devil. Oh, cool it, eh? Look, he's only trained on somebody else's boots. It's so fine out they're a bit too big for him.
Hey, darling, a word.
I just got this craving for a tomato juice. Isn't it funny? I mean, you know how seldom.
Can I have a tomato juice for her, love?
Oh.
Tomato juice, nothing in it.
No, just a tomato juice, thank you.
Come here, look.
Tell you the facts of life now.
I want you to do me a favour.
Yeah.
Or to be more precise, I want you to do Renee Roberts a favour.
Yes.
How are you fixed for spending some time in the corner shop?
What about the cabin?
Oh, no, Rita will cope. It's only till Alf gets back on his feet, you see. She desperately needs someone she can trust. Oh, and she can look after Alf more, isn't
he? He's no better, I hear.
Not really, no.
Well, I mean, I'm willing. I'd like to help Renee out, and I must confess I'd enjoy the change, but... Well, what'll Rita say?
Ah, she won't mind. She'll enjoy the chance of doing a good turn to Renee. Now, you leave Rita to me.
I do like having my dinner with you, Brian.
Yeah, it's a pity we can't do it more often.
Well, it's only because I helped Emily sort out the freezer last night. She said I could have an extra half hour.
See, if you didn't work on a calf, we could have all our dinner times together.
Well, I have to work. It's my job. Well, until...
Do you have another lemonade?
No, thanks. I've got enough here. I was thinking something in the middle of the night. You know how you wake up and things go through your head?
Oh, I don't wake up much as a rule. My mum says a bombing room wouldn't wake me.
Well, I was thinking, I've been going out with you longer than I've been going out with any boy before. Do you know how long that is?
3 months and 4 days.
Thank you, miss. Yeah? Oh, Brian, aren't you lovely?
You're not so bad yourself.
Yeah, well, I usually get fed up and chuck them in by now, but I've not got fed up of you. Have you got fed up of me?
Does it look like it?
No. Well, it must mean something, mustn't it, us stopping together? We must have an awful lot in common.
Hey, up. Don't you two ever let go of each other. I'm beginning to think they've stuck you both together with that super glue.
That's just what I was saying, Mr. Tilsley. How close we are.
Ah, well, you better make the most of it. You're only young once, you know.
Hey, look at the time. I should have been back at Gareth 10 minutes ago. Are you coming?
Yeah.
Hey, up, seeing them two together makes me wish I was 21 again, you know.
Darling. I bet you had a real go in your time, eh, Bert?
No names, no pack drill, Fred.
It's all as the quiet ones, eh?
Yeah.
Well, it's definitely not the loud ones. I mean, look at you. You're as loud as Big Ben and you get nowhere.
What does she know? I mean, don't women make a lot of assumptions, eh?
Never mind about assumptions. It's not 5 minutes since you were moaning because you wanted to get married and you couldn't find anybody.
That were ages ago. Lots happened since then. And anyway, I don't tell you everything.
You don't tell me anything. I'm not bad at guessing. What What do you mean you're docking me flipping pay?
You were half an hour late, so I'm docking you half an hour's pay. All right?
No, it flamin' well ain't all right. For a start, I were only 20 minutes late. Look, ask Ida.
Look, I'm not arguing with you over a few minutes. The whole point is you were late. You did it quite deliberate, and you got somebody to clock in for you, which is strictly against the rules.
Well, everybody breaks flipping rules.
Not when I'm in charge, they don't.
Oh, I know, says you're in charge. Any road?
Mr. Baldwin?
Well, if he wants to dock me pay, let him do it when he gets back. I mean, he's the boss, you know, not you. And just in case you've any more daft ideas, that goes for all the girls.
Start straight away?
Oh, yeah, Mr. Fairclough says so.
What does Rita say?
Well, she'll understand. I mean, well, everybody wants to help out in a situation like this.
Well, I must admit, it'll be nice to sit back and relax with him this afternoon, knowing everything's in your capable hands.
Oh, well, I wouldn't say that exactly. Because, I mean, I've worked here before, you know, so I'm not a novice exactly.
You're a godsend, Mavis, that's what you are, a godsend.
No, everything's fine. Honest. Just fine. I said you could leave it to me, didn't I?
Well, keep it that way, Sunshine. I want to come back and find the business still a going concern. Oops, got to go now. My keeper's just coming. See ya. Well, everything's going swimmingly back at the ranch, so I can give you my undivided attention. Now then, when are you going to marry me?
Hiya. Hello. Give us a vodka and bit of lemon. Right. Dead fed up.
They didn't have half a dozen amazing jobs going then, eh? Betty, she told me.
They had one or two, but none just quite right, you know. One didn't sound too bad, but it were miles away. Warrington. I'm not commuting 2 flaming hours a day.
Well, there always seem to be plenty of jobs in the paper when I look.
She's not wrong there. Come on, let's see what we can find you. Here you go, look. Supermarket manageress, experienced person, able to work on own initiative.
Great. What experience have I got at supermarkets about a flogging sausages for a day?
Look, secretary, personal assistant.
Mm. I cannot do shorthand and typing, can I?
Not a lot you can do from what I can see.
Hang about, look, what about this? Bricklayer stroke, odd carriers, male stroke, female. Big strong lass like you, that should be a doddle.
I thought you were trying to help.
You see what equality's done for you? Now, before, you wouldn't have stood a chance of getting a job like that. It would have been... Yes, Michael, well, my ambition... Well, my ambition is to travel, to care for old people and to care for young people and to be a world champion odd carrier.
Oh, give it here. Let me look.
Come on, don't snatch. Let your Uncle Fred have a chance. Now, here you go, look. Bright young person for jewellery sales. Now, that's a nice little job, that. And you'll find yourself a rich husband as well. No, hang about.
Now what?
School leaver preferred.
Oh, you're too old, Chuck. Refined, mature woman required. Well, you're neither of them, either.
It's not easy.
Now then. Oh, here's one. Age not specified. You don't have to be experienced or a car driver or a qualified steel erector.
Well, go on.
Early morning cleaners required. Good rates of pay. Well, it's a job, isn't it?
Came a bit strong there, didn't you, Betty? It's not like you, that.
Well, serve her right for being so flipping choosy. One of these days, you know, Fred, she's going to need a helping hand. I only hope she finds one.
What do you mean you're docking the pay?
Look, I've told you. I'm docking half an hour's pay.
And I told you I were only 20 minutes late.
Look, I'm sorry, but I've made my decision and that's it. And anybody else that tries the same trick will get the same treatment, right?
Right.
What's she doing now? What the heck do you think you're doing?
Only claiming what's my own. I admit I were 20 minutes late, but that stingy devil's going to clock me half an hour. So I've 10 minutes owing me and I'm taking them.
Oh, Vera, you can't.
Well, just let him try and stop me.
You're only causing more trouble. Ivy'll not like it when she gets back from the dentist.
Ivy'll have to like it, won't she? She'll have to support me. I mean, she's supposed to be flipping shop steward.
Do you want sliced beans or whole, Mr. Tatlow?
Which is cheapest?
Oh, the sliced.
Right, well, I'll have sliced. They all go down the same road.
Right, off. Oh, well, stop as long as you like. I'll be fine.
I'm very grateful to you, Mary. Right, your worries are over. Well, as far as the shop's concerned, that is.
How do you mean?
I have come to volunteer my services as temporary manageress. Wages, hours and perks open to negotiation.
Well, you're a bit late, aren't you?
I can't be. You had no one this morning. Betty said so.
Well, you should have come this morning, shouldn't you?
I couldn't have to go into town.
Yes, after a better job.
What?
What's that got to do with it? I hear you want help and I'm here to offer it.
Well, Mavis has already offered and been accepted.
Well, I can always go back to the cabin if you want, Susan.
There's no need for that if that's all right to you.
Well, yes, of course.
Oh, that's not flaming fair. She's got a job. I haven't.
Well, I can't help that, love. Anyway, I can't stand arguing here. I've got a bus to catch.
Flaming gratitude.
I'm glad you said that. She wants taking down a peg or two, that young woman.
But why did you?
Well, partly because I agree with Mr. Tatlock. I mean, she came in here like she was doing me a great favour. And partly because I'd rather have you.
Would you?
Of course she would. How's better than that young scatterbrain?
And he come in here chucking his weight around, didn't he, Ida?
Just like a little one.
Andy docked me half an hour's pay on top. So it's up to you.
Worry?
To put him in his place.
You'd be mid bud.
Yeah, before he gets drunk with power.
Who is already?
Oh, steady on, lasses. There's no need to get so wet up. Listen, you'll have to have a word with him. I mean, you're supposed to be looking after our interests.
Yes, but we've got to be looking after Mike Baldwin's interests and all, haven't we? Oh, Mike Baldwin? He is bashed up in hospital. I mean, we don't want to add to his worries, do we? That causes a lot of fuss and bothering here.
So we have to put up with young Iron Marty, then? You mean that we have to stand for him treating us like dirt?
Oh, give up exaggerating. Look, he's young, isn't he? It's only to be expected a bit of authority will go to his head. Give him a chance, will you? For poor Mike's sake.
I'll murder that Betty when I see her.
It's not her fault.
Well, whose flaming fault is it, mine?
Yeah, as a matter of fact. You should have gone round to Rena's first thing this morning when Betty mentioned it to you.
The trouble is, you're too choosy, Susie.
Watch it, lad. You nearly made a joke.
Oh, cheer up, Susie. Something will turn up.
Yeah.
It's just I get dead bored. I mean, the demonstrating is all right when I'm actually doing it, but it's hardly what you call regular employment, is it?
Look, can I get both you girls a drink?
Yeah, go on. You know, he's not a bad lad in spite of what I say.
What is she up to with? That's what I'd like to know. I don't care if he does hear me. And I'll tell her and all to her face if she comes in.
Well, how do you know she's up to anything?
Oh, grow up, Chuck. Ivy. Oh, what it led us into that striker. Oh, what it made us stick it out when half of us wanted to go back. That's your Ivy. Sticking up for his rights. Where is she now?
Perhaps she didn't think they were all worth fighting over.
Oh, one of her colleagues. Victimised and penalised. And she don't think it's worth bothering over. Well, if that's the case, she wants pensioning off and we'll get somebody else to stand up for us.
Strikes me you can stand up yourself quite happily when it comes to crunch. I don't know what the heck you'll need Ivy for.
Because she's my mate, that's why. Or she was.
Do you remember, love, that day we had at the waterfalls at Aysgarth? Oh, it was a lovely day. And it was all muddy. And you kept going on at me because I didn't have proper shoes on. But I didn't care. I didn't mind ruining them at all, because when we got to the waterfalls, they were so beautiful. And then we went and had a cup of tea at that little cafe. And scones and fresh cream. And that funny woman kept going on about my sister. No use telling her I didn't have a sister. Then we came back through Malham and walked round the tarn. And by then the sun was just setting and it was so peaceful that we just wanted to stay there forever. So we booked in at that little pub. Do you remember, love? Alf. Doctor, I think my husband's coming round. Oh, Alf, please, please come round, please. He's opened his eyes twice, Doctor.
You're right. He's showing the first signs of regaining consciousness.
Oh, my God. Doctor, when will he be properly better?
Oh, that's difficult to say, Mrs. Roberts.
Well, sure you have some idea. I mean, a couple of days, a couple of weeks. I don't care so long as he gets better. It will get completely better, won't it?
Let's hope so.
What does that mean? You don't think he will?
He'll certainly recover from the state he's in at present, but as to what progress he'll make beyond that... Well, he's had very severe concussion, Mrs. Roberts. At this stage, it's impossible to predict just how complete his recovery will be.
You mean he might be a permanent invalid? Is that what you're telling me?
I'm telling you I don't know, Mrs. Roberts. And that's all I can tell you.
The Don't forget you can catch Classic Coronation Street at its regular times all next week. And it's Christmas in the Street on Saturday from 3 o'clock on Plus. Next tonight, comedy in Me and My Girl.
Most dangerous weapon.
We have ourselves a serial killer.
Is the mind.
What do we got?
Consensual sex and bondage.
Introducing Fitz, a brilliant new drama based on Cracker.
Are you asking for my professional opinion?
In a chilling UK premiere.
Revenge, execution.
Of mind games and murder.
Anyone's a potential victim.
Fitz premieres Wednesday night at 10 after Newcastle United live in the Champions League on Granada Plus.
Don't move.
We got a bit of a do-on.
Prime suspect.
I didn't kill her.
They call me Fitz. What do they call you?
Twisted pervert.
You are a killer and they know it.
We don't like conflict.
I don't like any breakfast cereals.
This is Williams, 5-0.
Book it.
Agitate the little grey cells.
Your father has absconded, and you mustn't expect to see him again as long as you live.
Hello, my name is Michael Caine.
Who said there's nothing to watch on television? There is, on Granada Plus.
TV Shop brings you Mega Jukebox, a great reason to dance and be happy. Get 200 original hits from the 50s, 60s and 70s, the hottest sounds from the good old days. That's right, 200 original hits on 10 CDs for an amazing TV offer price. Mega Jukebox is only available from TV Shop, so get ready to have fun. Call this number now.
Hot town, summer in the city, poetry in motion.
Enjoy three decades of great music. Order Mega Jukebox today. 200 original hits on 10 CDs for an unbeatable TV offer price. Call TV Shop now.
You think your child has a fever, but you want a second opinion and fast. Is 1 second fast enough? With the new Braun ThermoScan, you simply put it in your child's ear, and 1 second later, you have an accurate temperature reading. The Braun ThermoScan is easy to use on all the children in your family, even the big ones.
The new Braun ThermoScan, smart thinking, available at Boots, Superdrug and Tesco.
I'm doing great.
For more Ho 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 this Christmas, go to Smith's. You'll find Shooting Stars unpicked and plucked.
Right, something terrible's happened. I've lost my cap.
Let me see.
And Red Dwarf extended.
I won't be revolted no matter how you look.
Okay.
It's hideous.
Whatever they're into, get into WH Smith.
Because most Tesco stores are now open longer, you can pop in when we're less busy.
Excuse me. I want nappies for the baby, carrots for the donkey, and marshmallows for the Archangel Gabriel.
Follow me, madam.
Which means we'll be able to give you more attention.
They're for baby Jesus. I'm his grandmother.
And with more customer assistance, we'll help you through the checkout in double quick time.
There you go.
Right. Back to Bethlehem. Excuse me. Sorry. Look! Just in time.
Tesco wish you all a stress-free Christmas. Every little helps.
Are those hankies soft?
Kleenex Ultra Soft. Got a dry to the touch lotion. So much softer on my delicate little nose.
I've got Kleenex Ultra Balm tissues. It's my curls worse than yours. They leave behind a microfine balm with calendula to help protect my skin from drying out.
Kleenex Ultra Soft with a silk touch lotion. Kleenex Ultra Balm with a protective balm. Kleenex, a touch better.
Nurse your headache. Nurse your runny nose. Nurse your tickly cough. Nurse your cold and flu symptoms to get a good night's sleep. Nurse it better with Night Nurse.
TV Shop brings you Mega Jukebox, a great reason to dance and be happy. Get 200 original hits from the 50s, 60s and 70s, the hottest sounds from the good old days. That's right, 200 original hits on 10 CDs for an amazing TV offer price. Mega Jukebox is only available from TV Shop, so get ready to have fun. Call this number now.
Hot town, summer in the city, poetry in motion.
Enjoy three decades of great music. Order Mega Jukebox today. 200 original hits on 10 CDs for an unbeatable TV offer price. Call TV Shop now.
So tonight, if you suck, they come in.
An audience with Billy Connolly. Tonight at 10 on Granada Plus.
I always wanted one of them.
The Champions League on Granada Plus. Newcastle's final game against Dynamo Kiev live.
It's Aspria again! What a leap! Magnificent!
And Manchester United. Can Juventus be toppled again?
Astonishing goal.
The Champions League. Newcastle versus Dynamo Kiev live. Plus, highlights of Juventus versus Manchester United. Wednesday at 7:30 on Granada Plus.
Bodie and Doyle protecting a mysterious Arab diplomat pursued by mysterious and deadly assassins in half an hour on Plus. Before that, comedy with Me and My Girl.